Happy Monday, everybody. It's Coach Elizabeth here with Monday Morning Manifestation. And on today's show, we're going to talk about why bad things happen, right? Why do bad things happen to good people? You've been working really hard at focusing on positive things in your life, using the law of attraction to bring it into your existence. So then why do negative things and obstacles keep popping up? Well, we're going to pull wisdom today from this amazing book called The Vortex. It's another Esther and Jerry Hicks book. Totally recommend it. I love all their stuff. But Esther and Jerry Hicks explain what they call contrast, or negative things, obstacles happening in our lives, because it forces us to expand. So we can't know what we really want until we know what we really don't want. So a lot of times when we get a little bit sick, we want to get a little bit better. If we get really sick, like if somebody gets cancer, we want them to be really a lot better. If we have not a lot of money, we want a whole bunch of money. So what contrast serves as is a point to get us to get really clear on what we do want. And we can't know what we do want until we know what we really don't want. So that's why a lot of times you see people who are incredibly successful. There's about a million examples of them out there. Oprah, Jay-Z, all these people, right? Who had really rough childhoods. They had a lot of contrast throughout their early existence. But what that contrast did was serve to show them exactly what they don't want. They did not want to be poor. They did not want to feel caged, right? They wanted their freedom. And a lot of times that goes with having a lot of financial wealth, right? You can be free to do whatever you want, which they are now. So the next time something that you think is bad happens to you, right? You get a speeding ticket, or God forbid your kid gets sick, or you get sick, or you lose your job. This is really a blessing. And it might be difficult to see it as that in that moment, but really try, because what it's doing is this contrast is making you know exactly what you don't want. And if we didn't know we didn't want, we couldn't know what we do want. And once we do know what we want, we can then go after it. And then the end result is that we've bettered ourselves and we've bettered our life. Okay? So I know it might seem a little far out there, right? When you're having a bad day and thing after thing after thing happens to you. But I swear, if you see it as a blessing and you approach it with gratitude and love for what it is, it will go away quicker, right? You've learned the lesson because you pivot. You decide, okay, I don't want that anymore, so I'm going to do this, right? That job that I lost, it's a blessing, because now I know that I was in, you know, some sort of mediocre bullshit working there anyway. I wasn't happy there anyway, right? So it forces you to take action towards something better. So it's good. Contrast, as Esther and Jerry say, is a good thing because it forces us to expand. And that really is the whole point of our existence. So just check yourself throughout the week, right? Anything negative or seemingly negative that happens to you, take it as a blessing, because now you can move in a direction that is the opposite of that, which will then in turn better your life.